For Krima Media's Polity, I'm Sane Dlamini. Joining me today is the City of Johannesburg mayoral candidate and ActionSA leader and founder Herman Mashaba to unpack ActionSA manifesto. So, Mr. Mashaba, you believe that by fixing municipalities, you will be fixing the country. Can you tell us about that reasoning?
I think if you look at municipal structures or governments are at the coalface of service delivery. Yes, national government is important because that's where obviously you set the tone, the political tone of the country at a global kind of level. But at a service delivery level, municipalities are key. For us to really live in safe communities, to live in a city where we get regular and tall electricity, we've got water, we've got roads, we've got an environment where we can enjoy ourselves as human beings. So, and that's a role that cannot be played by national government. That's a role that is actually played by municipalities. That is why they're so more than key. And that's something that South Africans, for some reason, I think it's probably because of our historical experiences of being excluded in political participation for many years, people tend to actually ignore the fact that successful nations are based on the foundation of communities. You know, smaller communities take care of their own community, and that's where you, from the community, you actually build a nation. And that's something that, unfortunately, if you look at our government since 1994, we actually failed to teach our people to actually take responsibilities for their own neighborhoods and their own communities.
Mr. Mashaba, you promise to end an era of bloated, inefficient administrations that outsource core services to tenderpreneurs of inefficient municipal entities. How do you plan to tackle this issue?
It's actually quite unfortunate that when I tried to implement what I call the institutional review in 2017, the ANC sabotaged the process because I remember when I took over as the mayor of the city of Johannesburg, the city at the time was still dominated by ANC cadres. And to get rid of them was not an easy exercise. I was running a seven-way multi-party government. To remember taking over first day, it's an ANC stalwart, Trevor Fowler, who's a senior member of the ANC as a city manager. Now, all this Section 56 managers, these are really your key administrators. We're all ANC people. It was easy for them to really sabotage us. But one thing that they can now understand is that Mashaba has got unfinished business. Mashaba is now an experienced man. He's had 3 years of experience of really dealing with what are called snakes. We will deal with them. I think it's important for South Africans and people of Johannesburg in particular to understand that ANC, when they took over the city of Johannesburg, bloated it with this 13-14 city-owned entities, City Power, Joburg Water, Joshko, and so forth. Honestly, you don't need these structures. They are an unnecessary bureaucracy. The whole idea behind this was for ANC to provide their inexperienced cadres an opportunity to steal and give them jobs. You create these boards, which is an unnecessary layer. My belief is that we don't, as the city of Johannesburg, need this layer. We collapse all these entities, let City Power as an electricity department have an executive director responsible for electricity, have an executive director responsible for water, working with his team of engineers, not politicians and cadres sitting on the board, not having an idea what's happening. Because every time I go past somewhere, I see a water leak. I have to go through the city manager. The city manager must go through the chairman of the board, to talk to the CEO. Because every time you want to speed up, they will call that interference, that you cannot interfere. But ultimately, as executive mayor, take full responsibility for the performance of the city. I think this layer is totally unnecessary. Just in board fees, those entities are costing the city of Johannesburg over 30 million rands. You can imagine what you can do with 30 million rands. But look at the impact of this layer of bureaucracy that you don't need. You will speed up service delivery where you can actually save billions and ensure that you speed up service delivery. When there's an issue, you just talk to the city manager and then talk to the executive in charge. You don't have to go through this complicated, unnecessary board of city power or Joburg Water or any other board for that matter.
And your manifesto also addressed the issue of clean and neat public spaces. But I'm interested on how you plan, Mr. Mashaba, to work with waste pickers, especially in the city of Joburg.
Well, look, you know, waste pickers, at the moment, if you look at how filthy our city is, we need them. But I believe, is that the kind of work that anyone can be proud to see your fellow human beings, fellow South Africans working under these conditions? I'm not proud of it myself. It's something that I believe it needs to be addressed. The reason why these people are doing this job is because ANC government with COSATU and the South African Communist Party closed down factories. These hardworking South Africans should be working in factories, getting the necessary skills, having the dignity of work, not having to wake up at 3 or 4 in the morning, work the whole day, earning 100, 150 rand. That's why you see them, they cover their faces, because they can't even tell their children where they work, because it is not a job that gives someone the dignity. So I believe what we can do, let us encourage private sector investment, open up South Africa like it used to be in the 70s and 80s under apartheid, where South Africa was one of the best industrialized nations on earth. It was one of the best on earth. So we can revitalize the South African economy by encouraging investments. Don't allow the trade unions to dictate your economic policies so that people can work in factories. As I say, people don't have to do this job. But at the same time, what you do, encourage the communities and society, teach them about actually separation at source, so that when picks up the stuff, the families take the responsibility to separate at source. Right now, honestly, I'm not proud. Every time I see these fellow South Africans, hard workers, law-abiding citizens, doing the type of job that they do, I understand why they hide their faces.
And if we also address the issue of access to quality services, including primary health care, or maybe providing water, does your party, ActionSA, have a plan in place on how to reduce the turnaround time when people are experiencing issues in their communities?
Well, it's precisely the first issue we addressed around the institutional review, where we collapse this municipal city entities, Joburg Water. We don't need to go through that structure so that we can fast track service delivery. Everything falls within the city. Only the city manager is accountable with a team of dedicated professional engineers. If, let's say, Joburg Water, it has to be run not by a cadre, it must be run by a professional, competent engineer who understand water and operate as a professional public servant. Right now, if you look at all ANC municipalities, why they're failing is because they are run by cadres. And also, we've got to watch the system of their tenders, where tenders are given on the basis of connections and so forth. When you've put together professional public service, they will ensure that we operate within the law. But anyone who gets a tender to execute a particular project, that company qualifies to get the tender for the right reasons. I was reading an article. You remember when I took over the city of Johannesburg, one of the corruption cases I uncovered was the El Dorado substation. I don't know if you remember that particular case where we discovered that there was no substation and a company was already paid 66,000 rents for it. And it's actually just come out in the court even today. A Zimbabwean national who's in this country illegally. gave the city of Johannesburg a fraudulent bank guarantee. And you remember when I raised this matter, the ANC accused me, attacked me, used the media that I'm attacking black companies. Here is it. Now it's in the case. You know how I fought to have this company prosecuted and the money recovered. Here is it. It's now come out open. And actually, I would really want the media to retract the accusation of me writing this stories about when I raised this issue that, yes, this person is in Zimbabwe. How did he get the contract in the first place? And you can imagine, he's here in this country illegally. The ANC government gave him the contract and they protected him and unleashed the media to call me xenophobia, call me someone who's against black-owned companies. In the meantime, they were protecting corruption.
And we also have a major issue of electricity in our country. And in your manifesto, Mr. Mashaba, you say you will work towards ensuring that we as residents no longer rely on Eskom for electricity supply. How do you plan to tackle the issue?
First of all, obviously, we are addressing the question of some of the areas which are supplied by Eskom, like Soweto, for an example, and Sandton and other areas. I cannot understand why you can be the mayor of a big municipality like the city of Johannesburg. The biggest communities for the city of Johannesburg are in Soweto. When they have electricity problems, like right now, people of Soweto are under siege as far as electricity is concerned, supplied by Eskom. And I'm saying this is totally unacceptable. And I started addressing this particular matter when I was the mayor, that I'm going to take it up. 2 months ago, I raised it. And I find it really very interesting that a few days ago, I see ANC is now coming out with lies to South Africans and people of Soweto that they are having negotiations with Eskom to supply Soweto directly. But fortunate enough, I've already spoken to people of Soweto, not now. So I've started the discussions with people of Soweto even when I was the mayor. So I think their lies and their crookedness, it's exposed. So what we're saying is that we have to ensure that we can, as a city of Johannesburg, be allowed to where we can generate electricity ourselves, where we're going to fight to make sure that where we can have private providers of electricity, we must be allowed to buy from them. Why must we be forced to really only buy electricity from Eskom? So we will explore this to work with private companies that are in the energy sector to see if they can give us electricity at cheaper prices than Eskom. And we're going to fight this. If it means we'll use the cost, we will do so, because the only language that ANC understands if it's when you take them to court, so that they understand that we're a country with the laws, and the rule of law is very important for any country to survive, to succeed by respecting the rule of law.
Mm. And also your manifesto states that ActionSA declares corruption as public enemy number one. And you say you will also encourage and protect whistleblowers, which is very interesting to read. Can you tell us about that?
Well, I've just indicated to you a case which I fought already back in 2017. It took me how long actually to fight this particular matter. And I would really want the media in particular, this case, I just picked up, I didn't even know that this criminal was appearing in court today. In the 3 years I was this the mayor of the city of Johannesburg, established what is now known in the city of Johannesburg as Group Forensic and Investigation Services, and managed to really get General Sibiya to really be the head of that, and gave him the powers and the resources to recruit top investigators from the Scorpions to work independent of political interference. So in all the municipalities we are going to contest, It's a mandate. The marching orders are there. When we take over the municipality, the first thing we need to establish is the forensic unit, because we are taking over municipalities which were under ANC, where there's been looting with impunity. So we've got to establish this. There's a lot of South Africans who used to work for the Scorpions, a lot of South Africans in the law enforcement, the agencies who are today sidelined, others are now in the private sector. We need to get them back into government, so that they can assist us in ensuring that these criminals are arrested, prosecuted, and the money that they've stolen, we get it back. Whether they hid it in Cuba or in the Isle of Man or anywhere in the world, we will get the top forensic investigators to go and get this money so that we can bring it back to South Africa to develop our economy and our infrastructure. And for sure, as far as whistleblowers are concerned, the only way we can deal with corruption and deal with it quickly is when we can protect the whistleblowers, because they are the ones who are coming forward, giving us the information. I remember when I was the mayor of the city of Johannesburg, when I was dealing with this Alexander Renewal Project, people coming forward, how I exposed this, where people coming forward. But, you know, I remember at one stage when I was asking the city manager and the city's legal people and group forensic to say, can we encourage more people? And that's it. But they says, we don't have the budget. I said, you know, am I allowed in law? I'm prepared to put my own money so that we encourage and pay and protect whistleblowers. If we're going to govern on our own, it'll be easier, because then we'll pass some legislation to ensure the bylaw to ensure that the municipalities we run, whistleblowers are protected. When we take over national government in 2024, it'll be public knowledge that whistleblowers are going to be rewarded handsomely and protected. And anyone who threatens them, I can tell you, they will face the might of Allah. We'll put them behind bars. They'll never see the light in their lives again.
Your party plans to partner now with civil society organizations as well as NGOs to work as corruption watchdogs in the municipalities. Why is this important?
Look, when you run government, you don't run government for yourself or for your political party. You run government on the mandate of society and on behalf of society. So how can anyone ever leave society out of what government's role is? I think for any government to succeed anywhere in the world, it's important to really have the partnership with progressive civil society organizations that really wants to really work with government. And as a section, they say, we've declared openly, we want to work with civil society, we want to work with ordinary South Africans, we want to really work with communities to ensure that whatever services that we provide, we want people to have ownership of their neighborhoods, we want people to love their country, to love their cities, and love their country overall.
And lastly, Mr. Mashaba, what else does your party promises to the voters, and what can you say to those who say they will not vote come November 1?
It's a very, 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 very unfortunate situation for human beings to get to that level where they're giving power to politicians by not voting. Because by not voting, you've already given your power away to someone else, which is really very unfortunate. I think you become a victim. You know, if you live in a democratic, constitutional democracy like South Africa, we have the responsibility as adults to ensure that we hold the government accountable. And we don't hold a government accountable by banning tires and banning clinics and schools or staying away from voting. For any democracy to succeed, you need active citizenship. Citizenry, where every 2.5 years in this country, you have an opportunity, like now with the upcoming local government elections, people go out there and punish politicians, because that's the only way the politicians will learn. That's when they know that your vote is not a secret. You are going to vote them out on the basis of delivery. If they fail to deliver, you are going to punish them. But I don't know why people would really take such a myopic view that my vote doesn't count. How do we become 60 plus odd million South Africans? It starts with you, one individual, second person. That's how you make up society. every vote in a democratic dispensation actually matters. It matters and it matters more because that one vote can be the one that actually can change the trajectory and the collapse, if this imminent collapse of South Africa. So I'm really appealing to South Africans, please, don't really do it for Herman Mashaba. Don't do it for anybody else. Do it for yourself and your family. Hold the politicians accountable. You've been punished. You've been abused for 27 years of a democratic dispensation by the ANC. Remove them from power. Put someone else, and whoever you put in power, don't wait for 27 years for them to know that you're going to remove them. Make sure that you hold them on terms. Don't give them a blank check.
That was Herman Mashaba talking to Polity about the ActionSA manifesto.